Welcome to Casey's SEO, and for today's daily SEO tip, we're going to be checking out a plugin for video schema. So you can download this plugin from a couple different places. Now, you can get it from Yoast, and then you're going to be looking for the video SEO plugin that they offer. Now, this is just an extension to their Yoast SEO plugin, or we can get it from a different place almost for free. I'm going to show you guys this in another video, and that will be coming up very soon. So make sure you stick around, and I will put a link down in the description below pretty soon to where you can get this SEO plugin very, very cheap. But if you guys use any videos on your website, definitely going to want to look into some video schema. So we're going to look at real quick the Yoast SEO plugin, and then I'm going to show you guys another way you can generate video schema and add it to your web pages. So let's hop over to the computer and let's go. Once you guys go ahead and download the plugin, you're going to see a Yoast SEO icon in the dashboard of WordPress. Then you're going to scroll down to video SEO. From there, you have a couple different options to set everything up. For me, the only thing that I really changed was the embed settings. We have allow videos to be played directly on other websites, such as Facebook and Twitter, and then YouTube embeds play or make pages load faster only by loading the YouTube player when the user clicks play. The next settings that I made a change on was post types, which enable the video SEO plugin. So I just have post and pages, because those are the only sections that I'm going to be adding videos to. From there, you're going to go ahead and create your page, and then you're going to embed the video. So if you are using Elementor and you click on, you know, edit with Elementor, they give you an option to create a video, which you can just drag right over, and it uses the URL. If you use this little template, you will not be able to add video schema using Yoast SEO. The only way I have found Yoast SEO to read the actual video and get it to appear on the edit page is by using an HTML box and then copying and pasting the embed code for your video. Once you have that done, go ahead and hit save. Then you're going to come back to the edit box in the back end of WordPress here, and you're going to see a little tab that says video. You're going to go ahead and click on that video, and then you can tell that the video, or that the Yoast SEO is reading the video. So you'll see a video thumbnail here with your image. Now, if you want to go ahead and change, you can change that image, and then you can actually change your title and meta description if you would like. Now, depending on how many times you have hit update, you may come back and you will see the exact time set up back here. But if you do not, you can go ahead and import that or put that in yourself. And then you'll have a section for tags. Go ahead and put whatever tags in, and then hit update. Now this video will be ready for schema using Yoast SEO. If you do not want to use SEO, you can use a schema markup generator. So I will put a link in the description for this website, but you're basically going to click on over here. You're going to choose video, then import all the information from the video into the boxes here. Then you will go ahead and copy the script on the right-hand side of the screen. You will take that script then and come back to your page, click on edit with Elementor, create an HTML box, copy and paste your script, hit update, and then you will find that you have a schema for your video on that page. The last thing you want to do is double check that there's no errors with this schema. So you're going to go ahead and open up a schema markup tester. And this is from the developers.google.com. You're just going to click on either one, but we have a rich results test or schema markup validator. Go ahead, click on one of those, type in your URL, hit enter, and then you will see what schema is generated for each page that you would type in and if there are any errors on that page for your schema. If there is, go ahead, make some changes, fix it, come back and test it again. So that is two ways you guys can put video schema on your page. Now, just make sure you don't have double video schema or double any schema on your page. So if you're using a plugin that generates its own schema, make sure to double check that in the schema checker before you go ahead and add any like manual schema, because you do not want two versions of the same schema on that page. So I hope you guys enjoyed this daily SEO tip. If you would like to subscribe to the channel for more SEO tips, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And until next time, if you guys have any questions, please leave a comment below.